Welcome back. We're going to talk about the Azure ecosystem as well as the Azure SQL deployment options. Before we get into the deployment options, we thought it would be important to kind of get a general understanding of the ecosystem that's available.
You know, as Anna was building this series, I kind of coined this term ecosystem because I wanted you to understand the different parts of Azure that are kind of independent of Azure SQL, but yet integrated. So for example, in order to use or deploy Azure SQL, you need to have an account and a subscription. And you'll see that those are things that allow you to control how often you can deploy Azure SQL, how much you pay for Azure SQL, those kind of type things. The portal is going to be a visual interface, both through a browser, actually there's a phone app for it, or a Windows app that you're going to use to interact and do various things with Azure resources. The marketplace is where you're going to choose various products or services, and you're going to find out the various Azure SQL options you're going to pick from the marketplace. Now, as programmers, you want to interact with Azure resources, always with some sort of API or command line interfaces, and Azure is going to provide that. We're going to give you and show you throughout this series how to use different APIs, not just T-SQL, but APIs outside that to interact with Azure resources and command line interfaces, such as the CLI and PowerShell. The Azure Resource Manager is a very important part of the infrastructure of Azure, and it's a powerful resource that developers like us use for Azure SQL to deploy things and manage things within the entire Azure infrastructure. And you'll see elements of that as we show you how to look at things like activity logs or monitoring and so forth. Well, speaking of monitoring, Azure has its own monitoring system, and Azure SQL snaps into that monitoring system to show you various things like metrics or even things like audit logs. Now, you're going to deploy Azure SQL just like you might in your data centers throughout the world or even in a certain country. We have data centers that you're going to deploy to. We call these data centers in locations called regions. And you're going to see throughout when we show you different examples how we're going to pick a various region to go deploy something, or even in the case of availability, show you where you can actually do things across various regions around the world. And then finally, I'm sure you're interested in making sure that Azure is an infrastructure that gives you the trust you need, the security policies, the compliance you need, but also a service level agreement. We're going to show you later when we talk about availability, how we provide very unique service level agreements to make sure that your Azure SQL resources are up and running and available as much as possible at all times. So that's kind of the overall ecosystem of Azure things. We're going to use these terms throughout the series. We wanted you to know what they mean as you interact with Azure SQL. But I think it's also important for you to first understand, what is Azure SQL? You know, what does that actually mean?
You know, Azure SQL is a term that we really use to represent this family of SQL in the cloud. And there are really three main deployment options that we're going to talk about. And the first one is an infrastructure as a service, or IaaS type of solution. And this is just SQL Server running on an Azure virtual machine. So we're going to manage the infrastructure and the host, but you're going to manage the OS and the SQL Server. Now, there are some additional benefits that we provide just being in Azure that we'll talk about later. But really, you're going to get more benefits as you move towards a platform as a service, or PaaS type of offering. And the first one is Azure SQL Managed Instance. And in relation to SQL Server on an Azure virtual machine, we're really just going to abstract one more layer. So Azure is going to manage the infrastructure and the OS, and you're just going to be responsible for the server. But you're also going to get a ton of benefits around being a PaaS service, which you'll learn much more about if you stick around in the series. And finally, we have one more PaaS type of offering, and that is Azure SQL Database. And this is going to abstract one more layer. So Azure is going to manage the infrastructure, the OS, and the SQL Server. And you kind of just get a database which you can get running with. And because of the management that Azure has here, we're able to do some really interesting cutting edge type of technologies like hyperscale, serverless, and many other things which you'll learn about. So you've now seen the Azure SQL deployment options: SQL Server and Azure Virtual Machine, Azure SQL Managed Instance, and Azure SQL Database. And there are really going to be different challenges and solutions that might lead you towards one of these offerings. Stay tuned to find out more.